I'm going to teach you everything you could possibly need to know about overhead cranes. Welcome to Cranes 101. I'm Chris Whitney with Progressive Crane. With over 40 years of overhead crane manufacturing and engineering, we've come into contact with all different sorts of manufacturers that use overhead cranes. Some know cranes better than I do, some have no experience whatsoever. We've come across people that need a little more hand-holding and help filling in the blanks. That's where I come in. Starting with what is an overhead crane and drilling down to some of the codes and regulations, our goal is to help you establish a base level knowledge of overhead cranes so that we can help you pick the best overhead crane for your application. You ready? Let's get started. Basically, an overhead crane is a machine that allows you to lift a piece of material and move it from one location to another location using precise motion. You've actually been around overhead cranes your entire life.
What's gotten into you, Sheriff?
You are the one that decided to climb into this.
The claw. It moves.
Look familiar? That's all an overhead crane is. Aside from making your life easier, overhead cranes are used for two main purposes: efficiency and safety. An overhead crane can work up to 3 times more efficiently than a group of workers or tow motors. They can also be used in extreme environments to prevent bodily injury to the operator. Sure, they look cool, but overhead cranes can be used to raise the level of safety as well as raise productivity. So now you know roughly what a crane is, let's identify some of the components. Let's start with the most basic component, the hook. The hook is used for attaching your load to the crane so that it can be raised and moved. The hoist is what moves the hook. That is mounted to the bottom of your bridge. What moves your hoist from side to side across the bridge is your trolley. Your bridge is the load-bearing beam that the trolley rides on. That can be up-running or under-run configuration. Your runway beam is what allows your bridge to travel from one end to the other. End trucks are what physically drive your bridge down the runway. Think of a car. They have wheels and motors that drive them. Your control panel is mounted to your bridge crane. That's what sends a signal to your end trucks that tell it to move through a push button or a radio controller that the operator is holding on the floor or in a cab. There are 2 types of electrification systems you'll see with a crane. First, you have your runway electrification, which is what brings power from the building to the crane. And then, across the bridge, you have a festoon system or conductor bar system that brings power and control to the hoist trolley. Before we review the different types of cranes, if some of these terms are new to you, it would be a good time to go back and review what we provided. Our goal is to teach you, and repetition usually works best. Overhead cranes come in all shapes, sizes, and capacities. A few things to consider when sizing an overhead crane. What's the weight that you're lifting? What's the size of your building? Is it a new building, and is it adjustable? You want to look at the span of your crane, the length of your runway. Is it going to be indoors or outdoors? How many times per hour are you going to be performing a lift? And what percentage of that capacity are you going to be lifting? Once you figure out what you need, it will help narrow down your search. I'm going to break down the different types of overhead cranes. And I'm going to start with the most complex one, the bridge crane. A bridge crane system includes 2 overhead runways and the bridge that rides on it. It also includes the hoist and trolley that ride side to side, and it can be in a single or double girder configuration. So what is all this single and double girder nonsense? A single girder crane consists of a single beam that rides above or below the end truck based on whether it's a top running or under running configuration. Typically, this type of crane is less expensive due to lower freight costs for inbound freight, simpler installation, a simpler hoist trolley design, as well as it allows for lighter runway beams. A double girder crane design consists of 2 bridge beams, and again, can be top running or under running. This type of crane is a little more expensive than a single girder, and that's typically due to freight being a little bit more to ship 2 bridge beams. It also takes a little bit longer to install, has a more complex hoist and trolley design, and also will typically require a heavier duty runway. Bridge cranes fall into 2 categories. You have process cranes and you have modular cranes. A process crane is built for specific needs. Typically in a continuous operation, in say a steel mill or auto industry or container yard, CMAA classifies these as D, E, or F duty cycle. Basically, that means that this crane is being used for 10 to 20 or even more lifts per hour at 50 to 75% of the rated capacity. Modular crane is usually found in smaller industry. Typically, you'll see these in a machine shop or a smaller mill. They're more economical and affordable. CMA typically classifies these cranes as a C or below, but with a little extra engineering can also be a Class D application. Typically with these units, you're lifting at 40% of the rated capacity for 5 to 10 lifts per hour at most. So a bridge crane doesn't sound right for you. Lucky for you, we've got other options. A gantry crane is like a bridge crane, only instead of being suspended in the air, has legs that ride on an embedded rail in the floor or can also ride on the concrete. Gantry cranes are versatile. You can use them in outdoor settings and rail yards and shipyards for high duty cycle where overhead rails and columns cannot be used, or you'll see them inside when overhead obstructions limit you from using a bridge crane. Monorail cranes are used in production assembly lines or workers move from one workstation to another without having any side-to-side motion. Like a single girder bridge, the trolley rides on the underside of the beam and allows you to transfer your loads. In addition, you can also use a track switch, which will allow you to go from one monorail to another or transfer a load from one bay to another. Jib cranes come in a number of different configurations and are typically used when an overhead rail system is not available for a crane. They come in a number of different capacities and spans and sizes depending on your need. They can be wall mounted or they can be floor mounted and typically give you 180 degrees to 360 degrees of travel. A workstation crane is used for an individual user. They can range from capacities of 250 pounds to 2 tons and can be freestanding or ceiling hung depending on the space that you have. The key here is the ergonomic use and the versatility. So that's it. I know it was a lot of information, but this was supposed to be a crash course in everything that is overhead cranes. As we move further into the Cranes 101 series, we'll take a deeper dive into each type of crane and find out what makes them tick. Progressive Crane is a leading manufacturer in the overhead crane industry. We engineer and build customer solutions using all of the cranes that we just discussed. Our work is done in full compliance with CMAA, ASME, OSHA, and NEC codes. We also have AWS certified welders on staff. Your application is a little more complex. We also have engineering staff that can provide a professional engineered stamp drawing. In addition to that, we can also design custom below-the-hook lifting solutions to suit your needs. If you're interested in learning more about how overhead cranes can improve efficiency and safety within your plant, or you would like to schedule a crane consultation, please contact us and we will set you up with a crane specialist. For all of us at Progressive Crane, I'm Chris Whitney. Thank you for watching Cranes 101.